In the name of the Lord, who is the compassionate and the merciful. Dear students, I hope that you are doing well. Today we have arrived at the most important topic of our e-lecture series, which is Transformational Generative Grammar. This e-lecture is presented to you by Farooq Ali Khan, lecturer of English at Shaheed Benazir Bhutto University, Sheringal, Pakistan. Dear students, there are 5 sections of our today's e-lecture on Transformational Generative Grammar. The first is the nature of Transformational Generative Grammar. The second is deep structure and surface structures in Transformational Generative Grammar. Third is Transformational Operations. Fourth is Affix Hopping Transformation or Affix Hopping Movement. And the fifth is Flip-Flop Transformation or Flip-Flop Movement. The term Transformational Generative Grammar refers to theories of syntax which were first proposed by American linguist Professor Noam Chomsky in his book Syntactic Structures, published in 1957. Professor Noam Chomsky was influenced by mathematics, and due to this influence, he defined language in a very mathematical way. In his words, "I will consider language to be a set of finite or infinite sentences." When we observe this definition, we understand that at a particular moment, at a given time, at a specified interval, the number of formed sentences in a language is limited, countable, and finite. Whereas, if we keep on forming sentences in a language beyond the scope of time, then the number of sentences in that particular language becomes infinite. Professor Noam Chomsky, in his book, defined Transformational Generative Grammar as the ability of the native speakers to produce well-formed and grammatically correct sentences in language. According to Professor Chomsky, there are 2 features of Transformational Generative Grammar. Number one, the native speakers of a particular language are able to transform ideas into spoken or written chunks of language or sentences. And at the same time, the native speakers of a language are able to produce an infinite array of sentences in their language. The rules with which the native speakers can produce an infinite array of sentences in their language is termed as recursive rules. There are 2 types of recursive rules according to Professor Noam Chomsky: conjoining and embedding. Conjoining is the process of combining 2 or more sentences with the help of conjunctions. Suppose I have different sentences. Sentence number 1, I am a man. Sentence number 2, I am a teacher. Sentence number 3, I get up early in the morning. Sentence number 4, I drive a car. Now, with the help of conjoining, we can combine all these sentences like, I am a man, and I am a teacher, and I get up early in the morning, and I drive the car, and so on and so forth. So by adding conjunctions and adding sentences to these conjunctions, we can create an infinite array of sentence in a language, and this is called conjoining. Another recursive rule is embedding. Embedding is the process of embedding clauses within a main class. For example, I have a main class, the cow grazes the grass, and I have an embedded class that chased a cat. So let's say the cow grazed the grass, that chased the cat, that chased the mouse, that chased the chicken. So with this embedded clauses, we can also produce an infinite array of sentence in this way, and this is called embedding. One of the key area of transformational generative grammar is the deep and surface structures. Now, according to Professor Noam Chomsky, sentences are present in the human mind at two levels. Sentences that are simple or basic or kernel or having ideas or rough meanings are present at deep level. The way these sentences are formed at the deep level is known as deep structure. The deep structure is an abstract concept, that is a theoretical concept that cannot actually be seen or heard. If we look at the formation of sentences from the perspective of processes involved in it, we can state that generally a sentence began as a rough idea in the mind of a speaker or a writer. And this idea somehow transforms within the mind of the speaker, and it is finally shaped into a spoken or written sentence which we can see and hear. So, these sentences within the mind of native speakers undergo transformational rules. It is when we hear and see these sentences in spoken and written form respectively. And the way these sentences are formed after they are spoken or written is known as surface structure. So in simple words, the native speakers, they have this ability to transform their ideas in their minds, and with the help of these transformations, they generate well-formed and grammatically correct sentences. So here is the entire model of Professor Noam Chomsky. Transformational operations are basically those transformational rules with the help of which the native speakers of a language transform their rough ideas or deep structure into sentences. And the first type of transformational rule can be called addition. The process of addition involves addition to the surface structure of a deep structure. And if you look at sentence number one and sentence number two, Ali is swimming in the river, there Ali is swimming in the river. Both of these sentences have the same deep structure. However, in sentence number two, we have an addition, and that addition is the word there. So we can state that in sentence number two, we have a transformational operation which is called T there. The second type of transformation in terms of addition is the empty it transformation. If you look at the same sentence which we came across in sentence number one and sentence number two, it is Ali who is swimming in the river. We can also see that sentence 1, 2 and 3, they share the same basic structure. However, 2 and 3 have certain addition. In sentence number 2, we have transformation there, and in sentence number 3, we have transformation it. Similarly, if you look at sentence number 4 and 5, Ali eats apples and apples are eaten by Ali. In sentence number 5, which is the passive transformation, we can see that are and by are additions to the surface structure. Whereas sentence 4 and 5, they share the same deep structure. The second type of transformational operation is copying, and copying can be illustrated with the help of tags or T-tags. For example, in sentence number 1, I can't swim, can I? Here, the subject I and the modal verb can, they are copied at the end of the sentence. These terms are not part of the deep structure of this sentence. Similarly, we have another example, Ali can't swim, can he? Here again, we have copied he instead of Ali, as well as the modal verb can. Now, these terms cannot be found in the deep structure or the rough idea which underlines this sentence. Finally, we come to the transformational operation of deletion in English language. And a very good example of deletion is the transformation of imperative or T imperatives. If you look at sentence number 1, be quiet, and sentence number 2, you must be quiet. These sentences share the same deep structure, but in sentence number 1, you must has been deleted, so the sentence is be quiet. Some of the students, when they look into imperatives, they need to remind themselves that a sentence or a major sentence in English language can always pass the subject predicate test. So be quiet could not have been a major sentence if it could have not passed the subject predicate test. So be quiet, it has this subject, but it is not visible due to the transformational imperative operation or the deletion of you must. Another example of deletion is the optional deletion of an indefinite agent in passive sentences. For example, in sentence number 3, we have someone must help Ali. If we change the sentence to passive, the sentence will become Ali must be helped by someone. And if we look at sentence number 5, Ali must be helped by and someone have been deleted. In the end, we can state that sentence 3, 4, 5, they share the same deep structure. After discussing the transformational operations of addition, copying, and deletion, we come to one of the most important transformation, which is part of almost every sentence, or at least sentences which requires case and agreement in the English language. Affix hopping transformation is the rule with which we place the endings in a position to which they belong after the verb in a sentence. For example, we have the sentence, Ali reads the book. Now, in our deep structure, this sentence would look like, Ali, present, read the book. The transformational operation, when they are applied to the base, it takes the shape of a syntactic tree. For example, this sentence, first it is divided into a noun phrase and a verb phrase. The noun phrase then constitutes the noun. The noun is Ali in the sentence. The verb phrase, it constitutes the main verb and the noun phrase. The main verb is read, and then the noun phrase after the main verb is determiner and noun. The determiner is the, and the noun is book. So the base is Ali, present, read the book. So when the transformations are happening, when the Affix hopping rule is applied, the read, when it is in the present tense and when it is used with the proper nouns or the third person singular pronouns, then the verb must agree to its case, and we add s or es at the end of the first form of verb. Now this addition of s or es to the first form of verb in the cases of third person singular pronouns, he, she, and it, and proper nouns, it is called Affix hopping transformation. So with Affix hopping transformation, the base becomes Ali reads the book. Finally, we come to the flip-flop transformation, and flip-flop transformation is the rule in which we first draw the basic structure of a sentence and then we indicate the verb within it. So in the Affix hopping transformation, which we were concerned with the case and agreement of subject and verb, and a very good example was the present indefinite tense. In the flip-flop transformation, we are actually concerned with the use of the form of a verb in a particular tense. For example, let's observe this surface structure or surface sentence, Uzma wrote a story. Now this sentence at the base or at the deep structure would seem something like, Uzma passed write a story. And when the syntactic operations or the syntactic tree is applied to this base, this sentence first split up into a noun phrase and a verb phrase. The noun phrase then moves on to noun, and the noun is Uzma here. Then the verb phrase, it constitutes the main verb and the noun phrase. The main verb here is write, and then this main verb is followed by a determiner and noun or a noun phrase. The determiner is a and the noun is a story. So the base is Uzma passed write a story. Now the tense is past. So what flip-flop rule does, that it tells or it informs about the use of the second form of verb in past tense. So in past we say write becomes wrote. So the surface structure would be Uzma wrote a story. With this, we end our today's e-lecture. I hope you are all doing well. Please remember me in your prayers. Thank you.